Well, Bob, here we are again in Paisley. Oh, same old smells. How long is it since we were here? Was it 1695?
No, we're here in 1695. I remember it well, almost getting flung at the tavern because someone got a bit too friendly with the landlord's wife.
Who me? It was all a pack of lies. It was her imagination. She was growing gracious, the secret favours, sweet and precious.
Aye, I've heard that somewhere before.
No, you haven't. Robert Burns hasn't written it yet.
Bob.
Oh, I feel it coming on in my head. I've got a song trying to reach through the mist in my brain.
Mist in your brain? I'm pretty sure you mean whiskey vapours.
Oh, come on, Bob. I mean, how many years have we been travelling the King's Highway, bringing the pleasure of story and song to all the people? It must be 10 years or more.
And yet it feels like 20 years or more.
Oh, look at the pleasure we've given. We've saved all these lovely Scotch songs, and you'll see, people will be grateful one day.
Aye, aye.
So here I am, Jamie the Chanter, for your pleasure. Songsmith, wordsmith, farm worker, seaman, teacher, layabout, traveller, man of the world. and with me, my good friend, Bob with a banter, a man whose natural intellect, charm and sharp wit are unsurpassed, except of course for mine.
Scottish Treasury, Visa and MasterCard are all accepted. And we're here in the year of our Lord. Say, what year is it?
Where did you get that gear? I heard that someone opened up a fancy dress shop at Paisley Centre. The year? 2013.
2013? How can that be? Stop it, stop.
Calm down. Maybe you got here in a time warp.
A time warp? What are you talking about? What's he on about?
Oh, no. Because there was that weird guy. You know, the one that gave you the scroll, he said?
He was a bit weird. Oh, that's right. He said he was some kind of tenant. David the tenant. That's what he was. That's right. He said he was a doctor.
Who?
Oh, that's right. Again, Doctor Who, that was it.
Who?
Doctor Who? That's
his name! Don't start that again. He gave me a stroll right enough. Now wait a wee minute, I'll just have a wee look. Here it is, the very one. Tied by a nice wee ribbon. Isn't that a nice wee ribbon on there? Let's see, what does it say? I mean, now, he said he had to go and do something. Something else in what he called the galaxy. I didn't understand that, but I just nodded my head anyway. I have to read this out in Paisley. Okay. Go on through time and don't miss goal. Tell the story all should know. And fear and prejudice both held sway. 7 poor souls died upon that day. They joined their maker up in heaven. 'Twas Paisley in 1697. Oh, that brings a tear to
me. Come on, mate, he'll be going on for ages. Let's jump to the pub.
You know, Scotland, this lovely country of ours, it endured many, many hardships in the 17th century. Many trials and tribulations. People clung to their beliefs as a way of surviving. And those beliefs have been won at very great cost by other people who've been prepared to die for what they believed in. I remember the Paisley Witch Trials, 1697. I tell a tale and it's not true about what people's minds can do. Believing things even though not true and saying it was witchcraft. Hey ho, the witches over garden, witches are lively too. Catch them, test them, jail them too, and let them burn in Paisley. Christian Shaw was a last devout, went to the cup without a doubt, and read the good book inside out, and prayed for all the family. Hey ho, the witches over garden, witches are lively too. Catch them, test them, jail them too, and let them burn in Paisley. She brought up pinch, she brought up hair, chicken bones and muckle mare. Nobody knew how they got there, 'cause the witches o' Bargarran. Hey ho, the witches o' Bargarran, witches are lively too. Catch them, test them, jail them too, and let them burn in Paisley. Christian Shaw, she did reside, in a great big hoosden by the Clyde. Our da was known best far and wide, John Shaw, Bergarren. Hey, all the witches, oh, Bergarren, witches are lively too. Dance and test them, jail them too, and let them burn in Paisley. I remember it was a real, real sad story. Now I've got my old storybook here. In this book, I've got stories and legends from all over the world. So let's have a wee look together and see what happened. Now, let's see, we want to get the bit about Paisley in 1697. Ah yes, here we are, here we are. It started something like this. John Shaw, a gentleman of good account, was Laird of Bergarren in the parish of Erskine in the Shire of Renfrew. Among other children, John Shaw and his wife had a daughter, Christian. A smart, lively girl of good intelligence, faithful in her attendance at worship and in reading the scriptures.
I see you are again reading your Bible. Christian, you are indeed faithful to the Lord.
It is my joy to serve the Lord in all his ways, Father.
Your mother and I must go meet with some people who have called to see us. Carry on with your reading until we return. John, you can go and gather with Christian.
Yes, Father,
I'll
go on your way. Come along, John. Good day to you all. My name is Christian Shaw, and I live in Bergarren House in Erskine, near the River Clyde, in the Shire of Renfrew. Our house is very old, with lots of rooms and lovely gardens. The roses are so beautiful, with such a lovely fragrance. My mother greatly loves her gardens. All my family are proud to serve the Lord in heaven above, and the Reverend Turner often comes to our home to lead us in learning about the Bible. I love my Bible. I read a new chapter each day. The Reverend Turner sees the Bible is like a chart used by ships, but this chart is for our lives here and there. And if you use that chart to see your life, even though the sea of life can be very stormy, you find salvation and rest in the arms of God. When he said that, I was so moved, I said amen to that. My mother and father looked at me with such love that day. My little brother John was moved too that day, but he clapped his hands with joy. I intend to lead my life using that chart, and I will encourage others to turn away from sin, dishonesty, and the black arts. I have prayed to God to help me with this task.
I'll have to tell my mother.
So what, are we back to your butcher selling, you asshole?
I saw you steal milk, Katie Campbell, and you know the stealing is a sin.
After all the years I've worked in this household, you begrudge me a sip of milk.
You're a thief, just a common thief.
Why, you stupid girl? You think that just because I'm only a common servant that I'm like dirt beneath your feet? Oh yes, you're supposed to be the genteel lady. I'm only the common servant. Do you think your father would employ dirt to work in his household? What would your precious mother have to say to that?
Katie? Christian, what is going on here? Mother, I just saw Katie steal milk. I saw her do it.
So, mistress, would you have me serve milk to this household that's not good enough to drink? How else would I know it's safe other than by tasting it?
Katie Campbell, how many times would I have read from the Bible to you? Have you heard God's command? Thou shall not steal. We are now just like a common thief living in our house.
Christian, are you telling me that Katie is a thief?
Yes, Mother. I'll swear a holy book if I have to.
Is what Christian tells me true?
There's nothing but a sinner and a thief, Katie Campbell. Pray for forgiveness for breaking the commandments of my God.
Katie Campbell, if you have stolen from us, then you have broken the commandment set down by God. It is very difficult to keep you here in our service.
I was only testing the milk for safety. How can Christian say these things that I'm a common thief, mistress? ask you if I give you any cause to doubt my loyalty to this house.
Loyalty to this house is as nothing when compared to stealing and lying before God. For that you face eternal damnation.
Mother, I saw Katie steal, Mum. I saw her do it. She broke God's law.
Well, Katie, have you nothing to say to this? Speak, girl.
Confess to my mother that you have stolen. Confess to God that you have sinned.
To hell with you and your commandments!
May the devil have you and your commandments through hell!
What did you say?
May God grant you forgiveness for those sinful words. Sinful words, are they? Well, I'll say them again. May the devil handle you and your soul through hell!
Kate Campbell, you will hear more of this later, and I will speak to the Lord about your insolence. Christian, come.
May the devil harrow you and your soul through hell, Christian. Shut up!
Go and get your father.
Christian, what is it?
She seems to be in a trance.
John, go and get Lily and tell her to come to Christian's room right away, and get Robert and Ian and tell them to come help you.
Okay.
The news of Christian's strange illness spread through the town, with both townsfolk and gentry intrigued and frightened of the condition, with some even speculating witchcraft.
I'm away working here at Kilbarkin, and I'm left with them myself.
Can you
handle
the
wind slip
now?
I've
got plenty of
them. Aye, well, I'll think about it, because I really need to keep an eye on them with all that's going on up at that big house. The winds are terrified. We're going to get taken away with witches.
Are you talking about that bloody house again? Are you going to let it go?
Margaret was telling me the
ways
are scared,
because
they better be
gone here. They are. They're scared. What with winds flying about all the place and coughing bits up. All the bloody stories I can tell.
Will you stop talking about them bloody witches? Come here. See my granddaughter Margaret? She's friends with own Christian's brother. I don't want her in among all that.
Everybody's fear of what that wee bism's going to say next. Even the minister's telling folk to calm down and stay away from their shores. Do you see that wee lassie? That wee lassie was nothing but a maid, and now she's a witch.
She did say.
Ah, wait a minute. Just because you say something doesn't make you a witch.
I know, but what she said was...
Listen, I don't care who's involved in it. As long as she doesn't start using my family's name, like, I don't care what happens.
Ah, well, just remember, only one of us could be next. Only one of us.
Aye. Only one of us could be next.
Gossip and rumour was heard in the big houses too, among the upper classes.
Well, that was a most enjoyable dance. And if I may be so bold, I was more pleasure was more heightened by the capabilities of my charming partner.
Sir, you do flatter me, sir.
The pleasure was all mine, madam.
Oh, we must also pay tribute to our gallant escorts in the dance.
Obliged, madam.
Have you heard about the ongoings at Burgand House?
No!
Oh, pray tell! I do love a bit of gossip!
Especially about Burgand House.
Ooh.
The mistress of the house there has done precious little to get to know her neighbours.
Oh, well, I for one have some sympathy with her.
Yes, I did hear. He has been seen in the company of a lady from the port of Greenock.
Ladies, ladies, what are you about?
Oh, this is gossip. I simply must hear it all.
Well, there have been some very strange goings on there.
Strange? In what ways?
Well, rumour has it there is something there that has the mark of the black arts.
Black arts?
Yes.
Oh, you are certain?
Yes.
This cannot be true. Why, the Shaws are a fine, upstanding family.
Well, young Christian, it is rumoured, has been cursed and possessed by the devil himself.
What's the wet part?
No! What's not young Christian,
yes. Yes.
But she's a fine girl. She reads her Bible every day.
Oh! Tell us, what is it said that I'm
doing?
Ladies, what are you all so serious about? You're like a coven!
I do not think that is a very good choice of words coming from you, sir.
Oh. Well,
what is the subject of your anxiety here?
Well,
and may I have assistance?
I'm going to have another drink of that port.
Well,
ladies, to your tale if you please.
Oh, Reverend, what I'm about to say, as a true handmaiden of the Lord, is uttered with extreme difficulty.
Fear not, sister in Christ. The Lord will give you strength.
Amen.
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 Well, my tale is about witchcraft.
Oh, God bless us and protect us all!
Mistress Nodgrass, do accompany me for a small glass of port.
This is all too, too much.
Yes, isn't it dreadful in our very own town?
The daughter's worsening condition. Laird and Lady Shaw took Christian to the well-respected and renowned Dr. Brisbane in the hope of a cure.
I am Matthew Brisbane, a well-respected doctor and Glasgow's physician. I was born in Erskine, where my father was parish minister there. I received a classic education in Glasgow. Then I went to Europe, to Utrecht, where I studied medicine. I got my MD degree in 1661. From 75 to 76, I was Dean of the School of Medicine at Glasgow University. Then a year later, I became rector, and I was there for 4 years. Lately, I've been hearing rumours about witchcraft in Erskine, but I don't believe that. Has there been no big witchcraft trials since 1662? Recently, I was contacted by the current leader of Bagarin about his daughter. as my knowledge of medical matters and mental health are well known. I know that with my extensive knowledge, I shall cure the child of what ails her. Gown. Let me be the judge of that. Just a second question. How are you going to do this? No problems? It's good. I hear you come from Erskine. I used to live there as a wee boy. I do miss it so much. I really don't know why you're here. You're a picture of health to me.
I'm going to have a fair.
I've seen this kind of thing before. Your daughter is suffering from hypochondriac melancholy. I have prescribed a course of treatment for her, and I wish it to be 10 days. As people in Christian situation have a tendency to do strange things, which are deceptive to the onlooker.
Deception is not in my child's nature.
Please, Lady Began, I'm referring to the nature of the illness. The child has no conscious knowledge of what she does.
Why do you hurt me, Katie? I never did you wrong. Let's shake hands and be friends like before. Well, if you would not shake hands with me, then I could not help you.
Days later, Dr. Brisbane welcomes Mr. Henry Marshall, the apothecary.
How do you show me?
Ah, Dr. Brisbane.
Welcome, Mr. Marshall. Would you like a drink?
No, thanks.
Right. I gather that the apothecary has asked you to assist in this matter with Doctor.
Yes, Doctor. The lad is very insistent on the matter. How is the child?
As you can see, she's resting at the moment. I have her under observation for 10 days.
What was your diagnosis?
Hypochondriac melancholy. I have prescribed a course of treatment for her, and I wish you to help with some suitable medicines.
Has she done anything unusual?
Yes. On her first day, she had a strong fit and had a conversation with an invisible tormentor.
I've been hearing talk of witchcraft.
No, I can assure you, it has nothing to do with magic. The child is resting and is improving.
Are you changing the medicine?
Oh yes, I'd like to try something different, and you can help me. Richard, that's my list of medicines.
I'll get these for you right away. Good day, Dr. Brewton.
Over the next 10 days, Dr. Brisbane tried every test and medicine he could think of. But when Laird and Lady Shaw returned to take Christian home again, he had reluctantly to admit.
There's nothing more I can do for the child. This is beyond my knowledge. I feel she'd be witched.
Yes.
To name her tormentors. No one was safe from her accusations. She's caused me for my farm. I know. It's terrible.
James Lindsay, and I'm a farmer like my brother John, and I've worked hard all my days in the land of the Garran. I go to Kirk every Sunday, and I live my life set down by the commandments set by our God. I can honestly say I've lived my life to help out my fellow man. There's nothing I love more than going to see my brother and his wife on the farm, and it's not far from the Garran mind. There's a nice path through the woods, and we can go for a walk, meet your friends and have a crack with them. But now we've been accused of witchcraft, and to meet the devil in they very woods, by the Shaws, whose land we've helped to build up and prosper. I know of my family's innocence, and God above knows too. So may God forgive the people of Paisley. because I won.
Innocent!
Guilty, I see.
John Lindsay's my name. I've been working in the land since I was a wee boy. My family's aye worked the land, so when I get a chance to have a firm of my own, I jumped at it. I've had a lot of success at harvesting the crops and cattle. I know the best bits of land and where to grow things the best. But now, folk are saying, I'm a witch. I've been walking in the woods with my brother Jim. I like nothing better. And we meet all sorts of folk there and hear grand crackling about all sorts of things. I'm a witch. I just want all this daft nonsense over me so I can get back to my firm.
Guilty!
I'm John Lindsay. I live and work at the farm in Bindarin. The farm is called Binloch. I'm what you call a cotter. Like I'm a farmer, but I don't own the land or the farmhouse. I have to pay rent to the log to live and work there. Now, I've always came from a farming family. I've always worked on a farm since I was a wee lad. Other folk have given me another name, known as the Bishop. I think it's because I'm a faithful servant to our Lord God. I read the good book each day, I pray each day, and I'm seen at the Kirk at Stambath. But I don't really understand what's happening around here. All this talk about witchcraft, I don't really understand. But I have faith in the Lord and his plan, and his servants here on earth, and my faith, will see me through. So the Lord's will be done.
My name is Margaret Fulton and I come from Dunbar near Dumbarton. I'm related to the Anderson family. In their day, I'm a witch. Me, Elizabeth's granny, a witch. I don't know how my family can do that to me. What have I done to deserve being called a witch? And my own kids and can't do. I feel so strange. Oh, thank the Lord! The fairies are with me! Oh, here my wee fairy friends! And they've come to be with me until they take me to their fairy land! Oh, everyone is happy there! And I know I'll be happy there too! What is wrong with me? It's as if I've lost my hold on what is real.
It's me.
But what is real is too frightening to think about.
Oh, come away, my wee fairy friends. And I'll tell you a wee story at your bedtime.
My name is Catherine Campbell. I came down from the Highlands. There was a terrible famine there, so I decided to come down to Shire or Enfield to get work. First, it was very difficult. People couldn't understand me. They spoke English here more than the Gaelic we spoke at home. And many's a night I slept rough until I heard there was work to be had at Bergarran House. So I got myself all freshened up and I went down to see. And I got on really well with the lady of the house. I told her my troubles and the good God-fearing woman that she is, she gave me a job helping around the house and looking after the other children and Christian. And Christian was teaching me how to read. And then I took a sip of milk and it all went wrong. They're accusing me of being a thief. And then they'll call me a witch. How could they do that? Treat us so badly. I mean, I know I say things I shouldn't. I know I've got a temper, but I worry about the future. If I have a future.
You're a wicked girl, Catherine Kelly.
Thank you.
name is Agnes Naismith. And I come from across the water at Kilpatrick. I've travelled the road this many years and I've done loads of jobs in exchange for some food and somewhere to lay my head at night. Recently, there's no been much work and I've had to sleep under a hedgerow and go as a beggar for food. I know I've got a bit of a temper, but I've never harmed anybody. But mind you, if I get started, I can't stop. But then here at Bagarin, they're calling me a witch. Me! A witch!
Who's a witch?
The bit for the pot calling the kettle black. Surely God will come to our aid.
My name is Margaret Lyon. I live over at Carpenton here in Orbison. Stay there with my daughter Martha and my husband's uncle William Temple. He's a cottage farmer there. Over the years I've brought many bonny bairns into this world, both to rich and poor alike. I mind way back when I was younger, I used to help out at the bus and people saw I was good at it. And so gradually I did more and more. And then the doctors called for me to help them. Now I'm a good Christian woman and I don't understand what's happening to me. People are crying me a witch. The self-same folk that I brought into the world and their parents too. And I sat with their kith and kin when they were into the good Lord's kingdom. I'll read my Bible every single day and I'll walk through all weathers to get to the kirk on a Sunday. I know God has got a purpose for us all in this world, but I cannot understand what he's doing to us to make us deserve this treatment we're getting. I can only pray that he lets me understand what's happening and what I've to do. Thy will be done, O God.
Number of accused groups, commissioners were appointed by the Privy Council to investigate Christian's allegations. Some 35 people were named by her, and the only way to save yourself from any more persuasive torture, and indeed the gallows, was to repent for your sins and name your accomplices. Some accused now becoming the accusers. My lords and ladies, as you know, we are here today to inquire into the circumstances around the alleged possession of Christian Shaw by the forces of the devil. Oh. We are thankful that you have come to see us and to relate to us your involvement in the tormenting of Christian Shaw. What is your name and age?
Elizabeth Anderson. I'm 17 years of age.
Elizabeth. Can you tell us what happened?
My father invited me to meet the black man at the garden.
What is the name of your father?
Alexander Anderson.
And when did this take place?
Just a short few weeks ago. We were to meet about midnight.
So where exactly did you meet?
In the yard, by the house.
Who else was there?
Agnes Naismith. John the Bishop,
yes.
His brother James,
yes.
And Magnet Fulton.
Oh. What else can you tell us about the black man? What was he wearing?
He had a bonnet, a band around his neck. My father introduced him to me as a devil.
Did this not frighten you?
I
go on, child.
I've seen
seen him many a times before.
Ah. Oh. Where else have you seen him?
At my father's house.
So, what was the purpose of the meeting?
To discuss Christian Shaw.
Had this happened previously?
What do you mean?
You said before you had seen the black man at other times. Did you regularly discuss Christian Shaw with him?
The black man told us he would stop Christian Shaw from leaving.
Did this not frighten you?
No.
Well, why not?
I was promised good rewards.
Well, so nothing was different?
No.
So why was it not different? Were you promised rewards?
Yes.
Yes. And are you willing to give testimony in a court of law?
Oh, sir, against my father?
It is the will of God that you cannot obey. Disobey.
Oh, no, sir, God help me!
Perhaps some time back in the toll booth would make things clear to you.
Oh, no, sir! I couldn't stand the sheep, the pig!
There, there, my child. No one is trying to make you do anything against your will. But giving your testimony is God's will for you.
Very well. I'll give my testimony to the court.
Thank you.
Liar!
Liar! Liar! As more and more people were accused and named as witches, some people were starting to question as to who were the innocent parties and who was really guilty.
See when we go to the...
Even among the ministers of religion, there was some questioning as to what was really happening in this.
My name is Sarah Brown, and I'm the Honourable Reverend Brown's wife. I do live an honest life. I feel like living between what feels like two worlds. The real world, in which bills must be paid and housework completed, and the other, in which we are revered by the wealthy townsfolk, we're respected. Some people thinking that if they're nice to us, their own sins will be forgiven. I do try my best at all times to be a good wife, aiding my husband in times of trouble. This time, however, my love and comfort does not seem to be easing his suffering. I've heard the rumours about the young girl's fits and her coughing bits up. But now, I am doubting an ailing child. I am questioning her words. People who have never set eyes on her are bewitching her. People watching her from a distance. For what reason would she have to lie? And now, I believe in my own pure heart that she is damning people to hell. And if you're hungry.
I'm all right, dear. I'll eat later.
How are things going?
You know that I can't discuss what's going on with you. You know that I'm bound.
Bound by your vows. I know. You tell me the same thing every day. Your vows, your vows. I'm your wife. I vowed to help you in times of trouble, times like this. Don't force me to break my vow to you and to God.
If only...
Just tell me what's happening!
They won't confess. None of them will confess. And they'll bum for it. Sure as God, I know it.
Are they guilty?
You've been to town. And you've heard the rumours. I saw the child but 2 days ago. I've seen her fits.
I didn't ask about the fits or the rumours. I asked that they were guilty.
Yes, they're guilty.
How sure are you?
Sarah, please. There's a judge who's investigating. There are people naming them as conspirators. They're guilty. What's on your mind here?
The rumours. You said I heard the rumours when I went to town, and I have. I've heard about the young girl coughing bits up in her fits. But I've also heard that Mrs. Shaw is a strange woman, and that her husband was laid with some women in the Port of Greek. That same woman has now been accused of witchcraft. A woman who has never set eyes on the child is bewitching her. She's just a child. A child is making these accusations. You have to stop the trials. Save these poor people's lives before she kills 7 people and ruins this town.
You have so little faith in me. Do you think for a minute if I could stop this madness? Would I just ignore it? Would I let innocent people go to their deaths? An eternal damnation? Sarah, I can only offer them salvation if they repent. And they won't. Damning themselves to eternity. Damning themselves for eternity. Because
when they say they are innocent, they might be telling the God's honest truth.
And they won't lie, because it's a sin.
Seven souls to face whatever the outcome might be for them. A trial judge was appointed, and the case proceeded along its tortuous path. I was appointed to preside over this trial, a jury, on 13th of April in the year of our Lord 1697. The jury members are all good, God-fearing people who have a firm belief in the power of the Almighty. The accusations are indeed very serious, and you have heard the evidence led on behalf of the victim, Christian Shaw, and her family, regarding her possession by agents of the devil. You have also heard counter-arguments put forward by the defence, and you have to decide if there is sufficient substance to them to add any weight to the case for the defence. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, have you reached your verdict in this case? May I have it, please? Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you. The verdict is that all are guilty as charged with the crime of witchcraft. Seek to sentence James Lindsay, John Lindsay the elder, John Lindsay the younger, Margaret Fulton, Catherine Campbell, Agnes Naismith, and Margaret Lang. You have been found guilty after a fair trial of the serious crime of witchcraft, and I must now proceed to pass sentence on you for your sinfulness. Silence in court. You will be taken to the gallows green of Paisley, where you will be strangled at the stake until dead. Then your bodies will be burned to ashes, and those ashes will be buried away from sacred grounds.
We have not committed no sin.
May God have mercy on your souls. The
The prisoners were then taken to the toll booth to await their fate, but their spiritual well-being had not been forgotten.
Let me all in here. Talk me down to deserve this. It's as if the Lord has forsaken us, and the devil is here, watching us, laughing at us.
Ah! It's little woman down to hell! And for any reason!
Beelzebub has mastered the unseelie sword. I know!
Snow, I do have to claim the Bentley over at Kennethal.
I keep your songs of Snow up. I've been paying no near this. There's no witchcraft at Kennethal. Nothing done with me. I'm not a spammer on my face.
Come again, ye fool. Ring-a-ring-a with the sun, thinking maybe with the sun. Come the crony queen,
The
Lord knows our innocent blood. Help us, Lord. Deliver us from this evil we're ensnared in.
If the Lord knew our innocence, we wouldn't even be here. See, what I see is the devil that's paying mere attention to us.
Ah, fish woman. Say nae mare about the devil. He needs nae mare heed. He's a faith in the Lord. He'll be so quick to abandon him.
The Lord knows the heart of your heart. He knows we've done no wrong. I'm afraid he will do as he sees fit.
Do to us as he sees fit. Silence! Complicit in our destruction.
Just looking on. Just leaving us. As if we don't matter at all!
Damn the souls to hell! That's where we end up. I hope to see them there, suffering with us. God help us all.
Oh. They think we'll be saved. We'll not be saved. They'll not be saved. But us, we know. Only the fairies can save us.
If it's the gallows for us, Christian will show her face before God, before she says we're innocent. She'll have us on our soul till the God makes his judgment. That's not it already.
My text today is taken from the first epistle of Timothy, chapter 1, verses 15 and 16. Howbeit, for this cause, I obtained mercy, that in me first Jesus Christ might show forth all long suffering, for a pattern to them that I should hereafter believe in him to life everlasting. Man, by nature, since the fall, is a guilty creature, and being guilty is ready to be jealous of God, as if all his designs were designs of wrath against him. Ye oftentimes so suspicious is man of God. That he is jealous of the hardness of his design, and that which is one of the greatest instances of his love in the world, and that is in sending his Son, Jesus Christ, into the world to save sinners. But I come to one use of this doctrine. If it be so that the Lord hath been pleased to give such instances of grace for the worst of sinners to close with Christ in order to life everlasting, then you may see such instances of grace are not given you to encourage you in sin. It is that it may be a pattern to them that believe. That you hereafter believe in him to life everlasting. One word further, and that is delay no longer. You have put it off before, and since the sentence, and you have been much dealt with. And now we have come within a day of your stepping into eternity. And we have come to you the day before your death, entreating you to put it off no longer. Oh, be serious. God hath exercised a great deal of long suffering towards all of you, and ye have hardened your hearts. And now we have come to you in your adversity to take Jesus Christ. And if you will not take him, then we are free of your blood. And Jesus Christ is free of your blood. And if ye should endure 1,000 hells, then you only have yourself to blame for the slighting of the great salvation. May God bless this preaching from his holy word, and to his name be the glory and the praise. Amen.
I wish to bring peace to my skin.
Then come with me, child. I'll help you.
I tried to understand what the minister was saying in that sermon, but I've done no wrong. It's as if there's some innocent victims, and the Lord alone knows why.
He wanted us to repent to get to salvation, but I can hear the devil's stoning his shudder, laughing at us.
And you know, while he was speaking, the fairies were there. All sitting all in a row, listening to every word. And when he had finished, they clapped their little hands and flew up in the air. And you know, they told me that everything will be alright. That we're going to go to their fairyland when we can dance and sing whenever they choose. And they said that you are most welcome too. You can come along. You'll be most welcome.
Yes, you'll be alright. Alright. Well, alright. The fairies will save us.
What in God's name is this all about? And I fear them. I know nothing about the deal. Nothing. I've never heard of any of this. I've never seen of mine. The
Where has it all been?
It's taken away my life from this earth.
We have reached the appointed hour for your execution. As is your right, those of you who have not already done so can speak any thoughts you have before you step into eternity.
God, have mercy upon your souls, and may his forgiveness be with all of you.
We're going to get ready to go down the night because it's one better than what I expected.
I know I'm innocent of all they said about me, but no one will listen to me. God above knows my innocence. You're condemning an innocent man to his death. May God forgive you all.
John Lindsay, otherwise known as Bishop.
I don't really understand what's happening to me. I've committed no sin. I just have to trust in the Lord and pray for his love to be shown in me and an understanding of his purpose for me.
Margaret Fulton.
I just want to thank y'all for being here this day. I'm so looking forward to going to Fairyland. I know I'll be so happy there. And I'll get to spend the rest of my days with my wee friends. It's my wee friends, they're so happy and they're so sweet and kind. And I love them, and well, I'll see you
later. Bye! Catherine Campbell.
I came here to start a new life. And here I am, being accused of being a witch. Just a young girl with so much to live for. Would you just stand there and have put me to death? I've done nothing! I'm innocent!
Agnes Naismith.
So you think you have to die?
Yes!
Well, I've got something to say. I am innocent as God is my witness. Now I am going to heaven to be with him. Of every one of you! and the field will turn to ash. I curse you for now to eternity. I curse you. I curse you.
Before God and all you people here today, I have done no wrong. I brought many of your bunny babes into this world. People have seen I'm a witch. But no matter how I say often I say I'm not a witch, no one listens. It's as if the world has gone mad. And I'm a helpless victim of this madness. God's will now be done. And I pray for you all here this day, and that I might meet my end with dignity, more than has been afforded to me here.
We will now proceed to the toll booth. On the place of execution, where the execution will take place.